Hey y'all, it's Tammy with Collard Valley Cooks. Tonight, we're gonna make some hamburger steak and some homemade onion rings. I'm excited, so ready to eat something good in our new kitchen. We finally got everything put up in the kitchen today and in its place. We actually did that yesterday and we worked out the sunroom today, but we are excited to be cooking again. Okay, we're gonna start out with ground beef. This is a good bit. It's about a pound and a half. And we're just gonna make some hamburger steaks out of it. Nothing special, y'all. Just some hamburger steaks. So I am going to add some onion powder to it because we're gonna have onion rings. I'm not gonna cut up an onion and put in it. That's probably a good teaspoon and a half. Some garlic powder. Some dill seasoning. Let me shake it. It's been in the cabinet for a while. And I'm going to show y'all around the kitchen in a few minutes while we're waiting on our food to cook, okay? All right. I'm not going to put an egg in here. I'm just going to let it just be plain on hamburger steak. I'm just going to mix this up with my hands. Make sure your hands are clean, of course. This is simple, dimple cooking. But so good. Let me sit down to eat. I have got some French green beans canned in my little pot over here for me and Chris to eat, because of course May don't want any. And make sure you get that mixed in good, y'all. Had a lot of stuff in it. That dill seasoning needs to be dispersed throughout the meat and not just in one big patty by itself. I'll do it. Now I'm just going to do like Mama did. I'm going to sit it down right here and I'm going to make patties and go ahead and stick them in the skillet instead of messing up my counter and having to wipe the grease off.
We're going to do salt and pepper.
Yeah, but I'll wait till I get
the
skillet.
Oh, you just put it on the patty.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Chris is the cameraman, y'all. The cameraman.
And dill seasoning is a lot like Worcestershire sauce, if you like that.
It's a real beefy concentrate, and it's concentrated, okay? So it's strong and salty. So you do not, you know, put too much in there. It's really good stuff. I'm going to make three patties, and I'll save the rest of this and do something else with it this week, okay? I'm going to wash my hands.
Yeah, it's actually a lot stronger than Worcestershire. A lot of people ask about it.
Yeah. Go ahead and show it to them.
It's out of Birmingham, Alabama.
Yeah. Well, I'm talking about Alabama.
Smells good.
Yeah, dill seasoning is some good stuff, y'all. It's good to make a steak sauce out of, too.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I got to get the grease off my hands. Then we're going to start our oil for our onion rings. This is a fast supper.
And we're preheating the skillets so that they're...
Yeah, getting them hot. See? Now we're going to turn on my little beans in the back. I don't know why, but Mama used butter in her French green beans and in her green lima beans when I was growing up. So I do it as well. So we're going to throw a little butter in there. It's just one can, so I won't put a whole lot. Just enough to make it tasty. And it should have enough sodium in it because it's canned. While we're talking about that, let's go ahead, put a little... Well, I'm not going to put much salt on these because we got the dills in there. And then we'll put some pepper on them. We're going to go ahead and put our grease in here. This is corn oil for our onion rings. This is, for some reason, I'm getting choked. This is my 3-inch cast iron skillet, okay? I'm just making it about an inch deep.
I'm gonna sit back and
see
so I don't get oil on stuff.
Don't you just love my kitchen? I can't wait to show y'all around. We'll do that in a second. Okay, we are going to use 3/4 cup of milk. I just had to buy cornstarch so I could make a mess for y'all. I'm still going to use a good bit of this. Use about a heaping 1/8 cup of cornstarch, okay? And then for flour, we're going to use about 3/4 cup. So I'm going to use my 1/4 cup. I'm going to turn this down. Okay. I'm going to turn this up. Okay. I got to make sure I'm turning up the right eye. So we've got a 3/4 cup of milk, a heaping 1/8 cup of cornstarch, and we're gonna put in 3/4 cup of flour. And we're gonna mix it up with our whisk. That cornstarch got in there and got hard.
Yeah.
I mean, you wouldn't think it'd do that since it was cold milk, but it did.
Yeah.
Now I gotta beat the snot out of it. All right. Now, we're going to take this over here. We're going to put some spices in it. Woo! We're going to put some cayenne. Some onion powder. Y'all just put in how much you want. Okay? Some garlic powder. And we just dip ours in ketchup, y'all. That's what we like ours in. So if y'all want to make a funny, you know, like a sauce, I do have a sauce in the second cookbook that's kind of got a kick to it that's good with some things. We're just going to do a little test right here to see how hot this is. It's already hot. Mm-hmm. Let's hurry up and slice our onions. Now, we want pretty big, don't we, Chris?
I don't like mine real thick.
Okay. Grass on. Now that's too hot.
Mm-hmm.
Now turn it down. Front down to about 6 is what we had our chicken on. Ain't it? You really gotta push them up off the bottom with a nice flat edge to keep from messing them up. When you put stuff in your meat, it wants to make it stick more.
But I do like it to turn brown anyway. That's how I like mine. And if you want to add a little oil to the skillet, you can. This is a little olive oil I got in here. These are my little new things that I have never taken the top off. Good Lord, that was on there. I will be putting that back home. All right. Let's get over here. Start some beans. Make some room. Turn that off, but don't unload. I'll make the thin ones first because it's so hot, okay? And I'm going to dip them and hand throw them in there because I don't want them to get messed up with tongs. Now, if you've got an onion and you just got to wash it, this was a layered onion, so I just took the outside of it off. Anytime you rinse any kind of vegetable or even chicken or meat before you fry it, you need to make sure you got it good and dry or you'll get popped really bad, okay? You don't want to get popped. My grease is really too hot, so this first set is going to come out pretty dark. This batter wants to kind of stick together. I'm dripping it on the floor with my fingers because I'm so crazy. All right, I gotta get something to put them on.
I thought I everything, and I didn't. I had to get a mirror.
Yep. It's hot. I need to take it off the eye for a minute.
Good, man.
You like them brown, Chris? Mm-hmm. Let me take it off the eye for a minute. I don't want it to be so hot. Now, this is electric, and I'm not used to it, so I got to slide it back here to cool it down a little bit. It wouldn't work like that if I were using gas. I could just turn it down. So, while we're cooking, I'm going to clean up the floor while Chris shows y'all my pantry.
Oh, the pantry. And we have, now we just moved on Monday. So if y'all saw the video on Monday, you know what all everything looked like. So this is our stand-up pantry. And it's really deep. You can see the width, how big it is right there. But we got everything stored in here with no problem. And we also have a pantry down the hall. And then we have everything down here. Got all our dried stuff. So it holds a ton of stuff, as much as a closet.
All right, you can bring them back over here for now.
I'm gonna slide this back on the stove, drop some more. Let's trade places, baby.
Okay. There you go.
These hopefully won't be quite as hot as the last one. Should be better.
We do have a hall pantry. I can show you that here in a second.
This is messy, y'all. You gotta rinse your hands.
Yep.
And go back. And then...
But if y'all saw the video the other day, the kitchen was totally stacked with boxes.
Chris, these are already ready to clean. You're gonna have to just stay here till the end. We'll show y'all around after we cook. How's that?
I just know y'all like to watch the food, don't you? You show them the meat?
We did not move out of Georgia. This is St. Mary's, Georgia. But it's near Florida. Across the river from Florida. It's pretty onion ring. Golden brown.
More like it, ain't it, y'all? More like what we want them to look like. I've learned that this stove fries on about number 6 the best.
And stuff. I'm gonna taste some of these for free.
You know what we forgot to do? Salt it.
Oh no. That's all right. It'll be good on it. It's like French fries.
Yum yum. Ain't nothing wrong with them. Salt them now. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah, it's a little messy. You make these, you might as well get your little kids in there and let them get their hands and all that batter and stuff. And
not just, next to the grease, though.
Just make a big old mess.
Yeah, it's Chris's bright idea to do this.
And he goes, Tammy, you're in my way again.
I want some onion rings.
And he was like, Tammy, make onion rings. And I was like, oh, Chris, it makes such a mess. And he's like, but we haven't done onion rings. And I'm like, okay, we'll do onion rings.
Everybody likes onion rings.
Let's put a little one in the big one. I gotta rinse my hands.
Okay. I probably need to eat this one.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure it's okay. Mmm.
That's really good.
It's on the onions,
I need to get them off of that and onto something so they don't get soggy. I don't want them to get soggy, y'all, so I'm gonna throw them in here. Okay?
Okay. Yeah, we'll put the batter recipe on the description.
Where's my lettuce?
They're all over here.
Well, I'll just pepper in all this over there then.
Yeah.
We'll eat it. It's time to flip again. I got spices over the stove, and then this is my baking side, and this is my savory side, and this is my savory and mostly sweet side. I tried to organize them. We'll see how long that lasts. See, if you got it about 10, you don't have to rush back over here and flip it like I did the first time. So you want your grease to be, you know, hot, but not so hot that you can't just let it sit in there and get the onions good and done.
And we're still learning this stove.
Yeah, y'all remember that I've had gas now for, let's see, 18 years. 18 years. So I'm not used to working with electric stoves. It'll take some getting used to, that's for sure.
They're worried about your beans.
Oh, for heaven. I gotta turn down.
Oh yeah, that's fine.
They're fine. But thanks y'all for watching this. And y'all know how crazy I am. I need y'all's help for sure. I need a wash rag out of here, Mr. Nichols. This is where I keep my linens now.
You're done with this batter, right?
No, I got one more brick to draw, and then I'll be done. These steaks are done. I'm going to turn them off. Okay. We're going to grab these out of here and drop our last group. I got water on my hands. I'm liable to get popped. I just washed my hands. See, there it goes. Get away from it. Here, I'll sit it over here so y'all can see how pretty it looks. And then... we got these to drop, and then we'll be done. These.
Okay.
I'm going to turn off my beans. And we'll get that meat out of there just a second. Oh, I got plenty more to drop. An onion makes a lot of onion rings.
Yeah, it makes way more.
That got some... well, I'm going to tell y'all this. Chris went down to the local grocery store down here in St. Mary's. It's a Winn-Dixie. May I say, if you're local down here, y'all do not have much of a selection. I can't even find Rocky Road ice cream. And so I had to toast my own almonds. Show me for a minute, Chris. I had to toast me some, I bought some Bluebell ice cream, chocolate, and I toasted almonds and put in it myself. Because I was in the mood for them, and I just wasn't going to stand for not having any, so I just made my own. Well, there's a will, there's a way. Don't ever give up. Right? Right. I'm going to fill this one up, y'all. This is going to turn over one big one like a funnel cake. Like an onion funnel cake. Now these little ones, the little easy ones I can do. I have a garbage disposal here, and I've never had one before. And it's, to tell you the truth, I've not even used it yet. This is more onion, but I'm just going to put it in here with that beef and stir it up. We'll make tacos or something out of it. All right, let me clean up my mess. You just video, baby, because you always have them staring at the floor or something. Oh, this is my cabinet. Y'all, look at this. This is nice. I've got my biscuit mix. I've got my cornmeal mix. It's got just enough space for me to put in a 5-pound bag extra. Self-rising, all-purpose. Just right here, ready for me to cook. All my sugars, my table syrups, anything sweet. Brown sugar is in that one. And Crisco. I got it set up good, y'all. I really do. I'm excited. I love my drawers. And then I've got all my Salad Master in here. All my heavier cast iron in the bottom because it weights it down. And that way it would make the drawers scrub. So, it's really nice. I need to get this meat out of here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just letting it sit and grease. But I have to clean as I go. It just drives me crazy if I don't. Y'all, clean as you go. All right. That's all we need. Look how pretty them are. Holy smokolas, look at that. That grease is the absolute perfect temperature. Remember that, it's number 4.
for these onion rings. Woo! When we make some funnel cakes, we're going to do that soon. As soon as the kids get here, in about another week, we will be making some funnel cakes with number 4 setting.
For sure. Get us out our little green beans. We'll make us a plate. Oh!
You mean to show them the pantry down the hall?
No. Not without me.
Here, let me draw my hand and I'm going to show them. I'm going to salt those onion rings that are over there. We forgot to salt them, Daddy. Throw them in there. And I think I'm going to get me some new paper towel. We'll make the picture with this one. These are pretty. Okay.
Oh, somebody asked what kind of oil we used.
This is Wesson corn oil. I use Wesson corn oil. I use olive oil, not with this, but just in general. I use Wesson corn oil to cook and bake with. I use olive oil for a lot of stuff that I cook. And then we use peanut oil when we fry chicken. And that's pretty much it for the oil stuff. And I use sesame. Oh, I use sesame oil if I'm making anything Asian, you know, like Chinese or Japanese or whatever. It's just got a really good flavor. All right, while this is cooling down just a hair, I'm going to show y'all around the kitchen. Y'all see my spices. That's where we're going to put my mixer. I kept the things that I use the most out on the counter. Like, I like sesame seed oil. I cook with it a lot. Soy sauce. I love having these handy. I love having these handy. I love this backsplash. We got this on Amazon. It's under our must-haves. If you're interested, it comes with the shelf and everything. It's so nice. Y'all remember I had this on my refrigerator, and I used to put my stuff on it. Well, it sticks to this really well, so I'm going to keep my whisk right here because I'm always using it, and my holders, you know, like right here. And that's so convenient when you're cooking, you know. I got my oil and my vinegar, my salt, my pepper, and those all just matched. A fan sent me these years ago now, and I still use them. And then, of course, we've still got our open shelving, and we decided to put one cutboard here, one near the stove, and that way I can use it better. You know, I got plenty of ways to use it. He showed y'all this already, but this is our cereal. This is my dry storage. This is all my cans. I just love it. And this down here is all my my other dry storage and my boxed goods. This is everything that's already open that we've used, like the peanut butter that's open and all that kind of stuff. And then all my extras. And then I've got all my little things out the bottom for like oatmeal and Pop-Tarts and chocolate, like baking things, are down at the bottom. And then come in here. This room is a mess as far as this goes. I still got to rearrange it. But this is going to be our coffee bar, because down here we have to use water out of a jug. So this is where we're going to have our coffee. Our water's underneath here. All of my things that I like to use pretty often, but not all the time, are in here. Up here, I've got my baking ware, cups for coffee. This is all my dry, you know, like my
paper goods,
coffee pods, and this. I put the microwave in here because about the only thing we use it for is to warm something up or for popcorn salts with it. So that's in place. This is our pantry. I got my Instant Pot so that I can just reach out and get it when I need to use it. This is all my cake stuff. Sprinkles cake stuff in this box. I can just reach up and get it out. And then I did the same thing. This is cake stuff as well. Okay.
And then we've got, you know, just extras in here. So I've got all my extras. I've got my cleaning stuff in a box. I can just reach in and get what I need. So it's coming together, but we got a lot of work to do on the office side. We've got this refrigerator, and right now it's got drinks in it, but look at the freezer, y'all. We brought all of our food from home, and it filled up this freezer and the freezer in there because we don't have a standalone freezer anymore. But that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Let's make us a plate. Woo, them are pretty, ain't they? Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness, they're so good.
Crunchy.
They're so crunchy. Can y'all hear how crunchy they are? Oh my goodness. Those are better than the first ones because they're cooked right. Woo! Woo! Some good eating. Some good eating and easy cooking. Little green beans with some butter in them. Look how pretty our plates are. Aren't they pretty? Okay. I'm going to get the smallest beef. Usually I would put peppers and onions and all that on there, but since we're made fried onions, I didn't do that tonight, y'all. Fried onions. Now, on our plate, on Chris's plate, he dips his meat and his onion rings in ketchup. Y'all, when I make meatloaf, the man, if I make a good Salisbury steak and I make a good gravy to go over it, the man sometimes reaches in there and gets ketchup, and I'm like, honey, I went all that trouble and you're going to just pour ketchup on that meat. And he's like, yeah, that's what I like. And I say, okay. But I like, let's see if I've got anything in here for me or if I need to open something. I'm going to have to open something. We don't have any steak sauce open yet, do we?
I don't know. I think there's some Heinz 57 in there that's open.
Heinz 57?
Yeah. I know there is because I made steaks. So you're...
Where's my stuff? Oh, here it is. There you go. Why don't I just listen to my man, right? So I'm going to eat this with this. I'm going to put a little bit of this on the plate. We're going to pretend I'm a chef. And I'm decorating the plate with Heinz 57. How's that? I hope that you guys are excited about our move, as excited as we are. We're going to be very happy down here being able to fish and cook and enjoy our kids and watch our dogs run around the backyard, have a nice big garden. It's just exciting. That's plenty done. See, y'all, for y'all that like it done, there's my chef sauce. Smoking hot. Onion rings. If you're stuck at home, quarantined, you got an onion and you got some cornstarch and flour. Mix you up some good batter. Make some homemade onion rings. Yeah, you got to clean up the mess, but just save the grease for the next day. And make you some funnel cakes. Hopefully it won't taste like onions. I'm going to try to reuse it. Y'all have a blessed night. Thanks for watching Colored Valley Cooks, where we cook like Mama did. We'll be praying for all of y'all and for all of those in the whole world so that they stay safe and virus free. Love you. Bye.